Would anybody like to answer before I start telling about the briefs of this concept? For example, we are now doing this, we're giving this feature like video calling, the prospects would talk to each other without disclosing their numbers. That's one feature. So because if you see girls specifically, when they were speaking to people, their numbers were disclosed. So their identity was exposed. Now that is not the case. They are able to talk to a prospect, and if interested, then only they would talk ahead. But their information would remain confidential. That's what is happening. Then we have got another one, which is sharing the link of that video, which expires automatically after a given time. Like for example, when these people talk, they say, I'm going to share my video. When would you be able to see? So say, sir, I will see by 5 p.m. Suppose the other person says. So they put up a time on that link, and 5 p.m. the video automatically expires. So the chances of misutilization of a video, of maybe unnecessary sharings or all those things, is put to minimum with this time-bound link that we are giving. So this is another one. Then we are giving the best of horoscope features that is there available in the country today. That is another feature that we are giving. Now we are giving any number of photos that people can bring in up. They can put up any amount of photos and videos that we have permitted them to do that. That is another feature that we are giving. So like that, there are some unique features that we are giving. That's what the intention is. So we have kept up users as our main concentration, where we are trying to be in terms of verified profiles that we are giving up, because we are taking only profiles who would be with those government document credentials like Aadhaar card or all those things. That has been given some by people also, but then we are also incorporating that. So those things. So these are some of the things that we have designed for users as such. Apart from these, we have thought that people would be interested in features like where they would come and see each other through video calling part that I said that is happening. Then we felt that people would want to chat as well. That feature is also there. So there are some unique features that we have built in only on keeping the users in mind, which today is not happening in the industry. So that makes us a different strategy in terms of online matrimony as such is concerned.
And KPMG, firstly in 2016 and followed by 2019 also. 2016 reports are available on the public domain with the name of the Google KPMG reports. As per them, between 2019 to 2021, around 60 lakhs marriages will be there. And it's a, when we talk about online matrimony, it's a 6% of total marriages. Right now, somewhere around 43 million people are using internet for the online matrimony purpose. And matrimony words reached 11th most popular search in the Google. From 13, that's the most interesting part. Somewhere around Google says 11% of internet traffic is just due to the matrimony uses. That is a huge market across the country.